Today, I'll show you how to travel from Lisbon to Madrid by train, while also taking the opportunity to enjoy a leisurely journey and explore Badajoz for a few hours. This approach combines the convenience of traveling between two cities with the relaxation of a slow-paced journey, without the stress of airports or driving. Join me on this trip and gather ideas for your own travel plans. Olá e bem-vindos a Lisboa Santa Apolónia! Hi and welcome to Lisboa Santa Apolónia, our departure point for this trip to Madrid, by train, in one day. When considering a trip from Lisboa to Madrid or vice versa, taking the train might not be the first choice for most people. However, it's still possible to travel by train between the two Iberian capitals. The journey is relaxing and enjoyable, offering scenic landscapes and the opportunity for a leisurely lunch and a stroll in Badajoz. It's an opportunity to make the trip an integral part of the journey and to enjoy it. I invite you to do so on this video. Come along on this part 1 from Lisbon to Badajoz. I begin my journey at 7:30 a.m. from one of Lisbon's main stations, Santa Apolónia, taking an intercity service to Entroncamento. I got to the station just in time for the departure, and as soon as I board, the train sets off, marking the beginning of today's adventure. Back inside the train, this is what first class looks like in one of CP's Corail cars. These were manufactured by Sorefam in the mid-1980s under project from Alstom and licenses from the Bud company for the stainless steel car body and the Dietrich for the bogies. The seats are what you would expect from a product that is 40 years old. They come with a table, cup holder, bin, and individual reading lights. The legroom is very reasonable. Some seats have 220-volt sockets, but unfortunately mine doesn't. There is no onboard entertainment available. Lisbon-Oriente is our first stop. Watching the departure through the rear doors is always a pleasure that I can't resist sharing with you. I show you now the map for this 738-kilometer trip. It starts in Lisboa on an intercity service to Entroncamento, where we will change to an Allan railcar, a definite must-see that we'll cover later in the video. Our journey will then continue to Badajoz, where we will take a break for lunch and a stroll. In the afternoon, we will proceed from Badajoz to Madrid aboard Renfe's Alvia service, reaching Puerta de Atocha in time for a late dinner. Now I want to grab a coffee, but once more I find a closed bar on a Portuguese intercity service. Come on, CP! No bar service on your intercity routes? The bar area is beautiful and comfortable, but CP keeps the bars closed on some of their services. not a good look at all. With no onboard entertainment, no coffee and no pastries, I resigned myself to the train's rear view. Before reaching Entroncamento, I take a short walk to second class to show you the seats and the bike racks with room for two bicycles. I get off the train here, even though it continues to its final destination of Coimbra B. Can I finally get the coffee? Yes, at the station's cafeteria. There's also this tile panel depicting the Don Luis locomotive, which rests nowadays at the National Railway Museum here at Entroncamento. Check my video about it. After my snack, it's time for the day's highlight, the Allan railcars. These were manufactured by N.V. Allan from Rotterdam and began operating in 1954. Between 1980 and 82, they were equipped with new Poyo engines replacing the original AECs, and in the late 1990s their interiors were refurbished. Currently, they only operate on a twice-a-day route from Entroncamento to Badajoz and back. It's on this 70-year-old railcar that we will travel the next 174 kilometers of our trip in 2 hours and 45 minutes. As we depart Entroncamento, let me show you the railcar's interior. The seats are not, of course, adequate for an almost 3-hour trip. However, traveling on these railcars, including the seats, is also part of the adventure. If you are in an adventurous mood, they may not even be that bad in the end. There isn't a cafeteria or anything of the sort, so bring your own food and drinks. In particular, bring lots of water. Even with the air conditioning at full blast, it can become hot inside. Outside, there are these spectacular views. Approximately half an hour after leaving Entroncamento, we reach Abrantes, where any semblance of modernity ends. From here onward, the trains run under manual phone block, with the station master giving departure with the rolled red flag and the whistle. It's a nostalgic operation aiding the quaintness of this part of our trip. For a while now, I'll shut up and let you enjoy the trip, the scenery, and the ambience. Enjoy! Our last stop in Portugal is Elvas, a beautiful station adorned with lovely tile panels. Modernity is arriving here, as this station will serve as the terminus for the new railway line being constructed between Évora, Elvas and the Spanish border. This new line will accommodate speeds of up to 250 km per hour and drastically reduce travel times between Lisbon and Badajoz. I plan to film a video when it opens, which is expected to be sometime in 2025. We arrived to Badajoz at 12:54, on schedule, after a pleasant journey through stunning scenery. The narrow underpass leads us to the recently renovated main building. There are various lunch options available, including the station's cafeteria. It's important to note that Badajoz train station currently doesn't have any facilities for storing luggage, which is something that should be addressed soon. These facilities are very helpful for people like us who need to leave luggage while exploring. In town, there are private luggage lockers available, and on weekdays, there's also a left luggage service at Correios, right next to the station. Time to take a break and grab some lunch before exploring the city. In the second part of this video, I'll show you the trip from Badajoz to Madrid aboard Renfe's Alvia service. In the next day or two, I'll also be publishing a bonus video featuring some beautiful images of Badajoz. Subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss out. Thank you so much for being here till the end, and see you in my next video.